Namaste viewers, welcome to Sunita's Kitchen Stories. Today I am going to prepare a fry yams using sagu, that is sabudana. In Tamil it is called javarsi, Kannada it is called seeme akki, Telugu sabu biyam. I have taken one bowl of sagu. In this bowl I have measured, in this vessel I have measured the sagu. I have taken this and soak for 2 hours. Clean it, wash it thoroughly, then soak it for 2 hours. Then drain the water and take it. For this one sagu, we have to take 1:2 water. I have taken in this na, so I have taken 2 of the water in this vessel. Other ingredients are green chilies. This is optional. If you want, you can, or else you can skip it. Hing, jeera, cumin seeds, rock salt, lemon. Lemon we will be using before putting the fry yams, that is drying the fry yams. Now we will start the next procedure. Now take a thick bottom vessel. You can use the cooker also. This is thick bottom, so I have taken it. Add the water, measured water, 1:2 water. 1 and 2. Let it get boil. Meanwhile, we will grind the green chilies. Take required amount of green chilies. I have taken around 10 to 12 green chilies, and I am going to add the rock salt in it. 1.5 teaspoon of rock salt is enough. I will grind this to a fine paste. Now the water has started boiling. First we will add the grinded chili paste to it. Chili paste, chili and salt I have grinded, that I am going to add to it. Now at this stage, just taste a bit of water and see, check whether the salt is enough is not. I checked. This needs some more salt, so I am going to add another teaspoons of salt. You can check at this stage and adjust it according to your taste. To this itself I am going to add hing, a tablespoon of hing, and 1.5 tablespoon of cumin seeds. Cumin seeds and hing help in digestion. Now we will start adding sagu to it. Soak sagu to it. While adding, keep the flame on a low one and keep adding the sagu to the boiling water. Now I have added the sagu to it, all the sagu to it. Now keep on stirring until the sagu become very glossy texture it should become. Until that you have to keep on stirring. Now all the sagu is boiled. See, it has become glossy. Now it will be ready. It is ready. It will become more thick in the morning. What we will do? We will just switch off the stove and close the lid. Leave it as it is. In the morning, I will show the next procedure. Now in the morning we will remove the plate and we will add the lime juice in it and mix it thoroughly. See, it has become thick and ready to prepare the papads. Now I am going to add the lemon juice of a 1 lemon. Mix it thoroughly. Then we will prepare the papads. Now take some quantity of mixture of the papad in a small one, so that easy to put the papads.
take a plastic sheet like this. Take a ladle of mixture of the papad and put it like this. Continue the same with all the batter. Now I have put all the frames on the plastic sheet. Now it will take at least 1 week to sun dry, then it will be ready for frying. Now after 1 week, our sagu papad, sabudana papad, is ready to fry. See, they have dried nicely. Now I will fry and show you. Now the oil is heated. I'm going to fry the sabudana papad. I will show some more papads. Now the tasty sabudana papads are ready. Please like, share and subscribe to my channel, Sunita's Kitchen Stories. Thank you.